Hello students, in today's video we will learn about reproduction in fungi. Now fungal reproduction is complex, reflecting the differences in the lifestyle and genetic makeup within this diverse kingdom of organisms. Now fungi reproduce by many methods, according to its needs, according to its functions, according to the environmental condition, isn't it? So basically, reproduction of fungi is classified into three main categories, that is vegetative type of reproduction, asexual type of reproduction and sexual type of reproduction. In this video, we will discuss each and every type of reproduction in details with their examples. Now we first come to vegetative type of reproduction. What happens in the vegetative type of reproduction? It is a form of asexual reproduction. It mainly occurs in plants and fungi also, in which the multicellular structures become detached from the parent plant and develop into the new individuals that are genetically identical to the parent plant. Mind it, these individuals which are formed by the detachment from the parent plant, they are genetically identical to the parent plant. Then they basically, in the fungi, there are three types of vegetative reproduction, that is fission of somatic cell, budding of somatic cell and fragmentation. We come to one of the main type of the vegetative reproduction, that is fission. Now fission is the type of vegetative reproduction in which the parent cell, as you can see, the parent cell elongates. It stretches out, then it's divide mitotically into two daughter cells. These daughter cells, first when cytoplasm cleaves out, then nucleus start dividing and the wall formation occurs between the two cells, and the parent cell divides into two daughter cells. So this is a simple type of vegetative reproduction, and it happens in Saccharomyces and many other family of the Saccharomyces. Budding is also the important type of vegetative reproduction in fungi. It happens in fungi and many of the plants also. So typically it is a feature of Ascomycetes, and yeast also performs budding. Now what happens in the budding is the cell wall bulge out in a parent cell. What happens? The parent cell produces the small outgrowth. This small outgrowth is known as protuberance, and these protuberance enlarges and then it divides from the parent cell, giving rise to another cell which is known as the daughter cell. As the bud enlarges, a septum is laid down at the joining of the bud with the mother cell, and the bud then separates and leads the independent life. And these small protuberance or the projection on the parent cell wall is known as buds. That's why this type of reproduction is known as the budding reproduction. Further, after the detachment of the buds from the parent cell, it grows and lives independently and thus give rise to a new individual. One of the important and very simple type of vegetative reproduction is the fragmentation reproduction. In this method, what happens? A piece of mycelium or a hyphae or the body of fungus splits off. Splits off means cell wall appears and detachment appears. Those splits off into two or three fragments, which eventually produces the new colony of fungi. As you can see in picture also, vegetative cell, then cleavage appears at the intervals, that is known as fragmentation. Now each cleavage or each part which is separated out due to the fragmentation give rise to new vegetative cells. So this is also a simple type of vegetative reproduction. It occurs in mucor. After discussing conidiospores and sporangiospores, now we come to arthrospores and chlamydospores. Now what do you mean by arthrospores? Now arthrospores is basically whenever the asexual reproduction occurs, it occurs either by the central constriction of the parent cell or by producing the spores. Now in both the condition, the hyphal fragmentation occurs and the resulting spores is known as the chlamydospores. Now its examples are Trichosporium, Angiotrichum are all its examples. Now what do we mean by chlamydospores? Now chlamydospores basically it is formed within the hyphae. It formed within the hyphae, in which when the hyphal cell contracts, when it lose water, when it round up and develops into a thick wall structure, it all occurs in the unfavorable condition. So what happens when the unfavorable condition prevails, then spores have to save themselves. Now what happens, the hyphae itself contracts, loses water, round up and it develop a thick wall structure on the spore, and this thick wall structure is known as chlamydospores, and it saves the chlamydospores from the harmful condition. And now what happens during this time, it is a resting phase, it is also known as the resting phase of the fungi reproduction, and nutrient is shunted from adjacent cells into a preferred cell and it swells up, converts nutrient material to the oil droplets for efficient storage. Then what happens, the round off of the hyphae occurs, which is thick, often roughened outer wall for protection. Now all these things happen. It is the main motto is to save the spores during the unfavorable condition, and this give birth to the new individual when the favorable condition arises. And the important examples are histoplasma and candida are the important examples. Now one more thing I want to mention, that when hyphal fragmentation occurs, the resulting spores, as I earlier said, is termed as arthrospores. If the cells are surrounded by the thick wall before hyphal fragmentation, the spores are instead called chlamydospores. And if spores are not produced in a sac but do develop at a hyphal tip or side wall, they are called conidiospores. So now you understand the different differences between each of the spores, either difference in their formation, either difference in their structure, either difference in their reproduction strategy. There are many asexual reproduction in the fungi by various spores. Now we are discussing here the main spores, which is of importance. Now there are the many other spores also which is left behind, so this is important. One also important is blastospore. Now what is blastospore? The blastospore, it is a budding spores. It is usually happens on the terminal end of the hyphae. Now you will ask, what is the difference between blastospore and conidiospore? What both happens on the tip, but in the conidiospores what happens, the spores, it burst out and spores are released into the environment, and then it gave rise to new individual. Now what happens in blastospore, the spore may remain attached to the hyphae and the bud further to guide branches chain of the blastospores. And you can see the second picture, the blastospore is a grape like structure. What happens in conidiospores, it is a linear structure, conidia by conidia by conidia. So this is major difference. Both is the asexual type of reproduction. The example of blastospores is yeast. And you can see in the first picture also, it is a microscopic slide of the yeast in which you can clearly see the budding pattern which is happening in the yeast, and this is type of a blastospore asexual reproduction. Now we come to sexual reproduction in fungi. Now fungi also reproduce sexually by also in means of spores. Now basically the sexual reproduction is carried out by the diffusion of the nuclei from the two parent at a definite stage in a life cycle of fungi. What happens in the sexual reproduction, we all know there is an interchange of the genes. So basically meiosis occurs in the sexual reproduction while mitosis occurs in the asexual reproduction. Now who don't know about mitosis and meiosis can brush up. There is a picture you can see. In mitosis what happens, spindle fiber formation happens, cell division happens, and the resulting daughter cells is 2N, means it contains both the two chromosomes, 2N number of chromosomes, they are diploid. While in the meiosis what happens, haploid spores are formed and they contain the half genetic material of the parent cell. It happens in the meiosis. Why? Because in mitosis only one parent is involved in a reproduction, and in meiosis two parent or a two fungi or a two hyphae or a two nuclei, two cytoplasm is responsible to reproduce, to develop a progeny. Now we will further understand what are the stages of the sexual reproduction in the fungi. Now basically the whole sexual reproduction of fungi, the process is divided into three phases. First is plasmogamy. Now plasmogamy can be also known as marriage of cytoplasm or fusion of cytoplasm or protoplasm. Now in the fungal life cycle picture you can see the plasmogamy is written. Now it is written, the haploid cells from two different mycelia fuse to form heterokaryotic cell with two or more nuclei. Now what is the meaning of that? Plasmogamy, as we all know, it is a fusion of protoplasm. What happens, the two cells, two fungal cells which is present in the mycelium is a net like structure, and the shorter form of the mycelium is known as hyphae, and in the hyphae cells are present. Now two different types of hyphae or the cells, haploid cells fuse together, means they are fused. Now when they are fused in the stage of plasmogamy, what happens, there is no fusion of the nucleus, only cytoplasm fused together, and the stage come is known as the heterokaryotic stage. Now this is important stage in the sexual reproduction cycle of a fungi, heterokaryotic stage. Hetero matlab different, karyotic matlab nucleus, means jab fusion hua cytoplasm ka, two different cytoplasm ka, to ek cell bana which has two nuclei, दो पेरेंट्स से जो अलग अलग न्यूक्लियाई दोनों सेल के अंदर है, एंड दैट स्टेज इज नोन एज, बिकॉज देयर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ न्यूक्लियाई प्रेजेंट इन द सेल, दैट स्टेज इज नोन एज द हेटेरोकैरियोटिक स्टेज. Now after heterokaryotic stage, those both nuclei which is present in the cytoplasm, now they fuse together to form a diploid zygote, 2N zygote. Haploid cytoplasm fuse हुए, heterokaryotic stage आई, फिर उसके बाद stage आती karyogamy. Karyogamy means fusion of nucleus. Now both nucleus fuse together and they form the zygote which is 2N. Now what happens after the zygote formation, the third stage is meiosis. It is reductional division of nucleus, meiosis. Meiosis mein kya hota hai, 2N zygote hai. Ab meiosis mein haploid spores are formed. तो अब जो स्पोर्स हमारे बन रहे हैं, हैप्लॉइड स्पोर्स हो रहे हैं, और इन स्पोर्स के अंदर दे कंटेन बोथ द जीन्स ऑफ बोथ द पेरेंट्स. So this is the cycle of the sexual reproduction. ठीक है। अब वो स्पोज जर्म
प्लाज्मोगैमी एंड कैरियोगैमी में अकर इन द नंबर ऑफ डिफरेंट वेज एंड डिफरेंट टैक्सोनॉमिक ग्रुप्स ऑफ फंगाई एज इट कैन बी गैमेटिक कॉपुलेशन इट कैन बी गैमेट गैमेटेंजियल कॉपुलेशन गैमेटेंजियल कॉपुलेशन स्पर्मेटाइजेशन एंड सोमेटोगैमी। नाउ वी विल डिस्कस वन बाय वन इन डिटेल। फर्स्ट इज गैमेटिक कॉपुलेशन। बेसिकली इट इज़ ऑफ थ्री टाइप्स आइसोगैमी एंड ओगैमी। नाउ इट हैपन्स इन द लोअर फंगाई कैटेगरीज इन विच मेल एंड फीमेल गैमीट्स मे बी मॉर्फोलॉजिकली सिमिलर टू ईच अदर दैट इज कैटेगराइज अंडर द आइसोगैमेटिक कॉपुलेशन। वैन बोथ द गैमीट्स आर डिसिमिलर फ्रॉम ईच अदर दैन इट इज एन आइसोगैमी और इट कैन बी ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज हिटीरोगैमी। नाउ वन ऑफ द गैमिट इज मोटाइल इट कैन बी आदर फीमेल और मेल देन दिस टाइप ऑफ कॉपुलेशन कम्स अंडर द ओगैमस टाइप ऑफ कॉपुलेशन। नाउ सेकेंड कैटेगरी इज गैमेटेंजियल कॉन्टैक्ट और गैमेट गैमेटेंजियल कॉन्टैक्ट। इन मैनी फाइकोमाइसिटीज वॉट हैपन सेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इज अफेक्टेड बाय द गैमेटेंजियल कॉन्टैक्ट। अ गैमेटेंजियम इज द स्ट्रक्चर इन विच गैमीट्स आर फॉर्म्ड। यू कैन ऑल्सो सी इन द पिक्चर इट सेल्फ द मेल एंड फीमेल गैमेटेंजिया कम इन कॉन्टैक्ट एंड पोर इज प्रोड्यूस एट द पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट। द मेल गैमीट पास थ्रू द पोर इन टू द फीमेल गैमेटेंजियम वेयर दे फर्टिलाइज द एग्स और ओस्पोर्स टू प्रोड्यूस द डिप्लॉइड ओस्पोर्स। नाउ द ओस्पोर्स विच इज फॉर्म्ड इन द गैमेटेंजियल कॉपुलेशन इट इज ऑफ डिप्लॉइड टाइप। द फर्टिलाइजेशन ट्यूब फॉर्म फ्रॉम द मेल गैमेटेंजियम एंटर्स द फीमेल गैमेटेंजियम एंड मेल गैमीट पास थ्रू दिस ट्यूब and the production of the diploid spores occurs. Third category is the gametangial copulation. It happens in the zygomycetes family of the fungi such as mucor in which the male and female gametangia come in contact and the entire gametangia fuse with each other and thereby they separate their identity. Their identity is lost in the fusion. From the fusion they produced a spore like structure and that spore like structure is known as the zygospore. You can see the zygospore formation in the third picture. When male and female come together they form a spore like structure. They both lose their identity and that spore like structure is known as the zygospore. In the zygospore the male and female nuclei is present and they pair with each other and eventually some of these pairs of the nuclei fuse and form the diploid nuclei which further undergoes the meiosis. Fourth and important type of sexual reproduction is somatogamy. It happens in basidiomycetes category, for example mushrooms, where specialized sex organs are totally absent. So the sexual reproduction occurs by the vegetative cells in which the male and female nuclei are brought together by fusion of vegetative hyphae originating from the mycelia of opposite mating types. And in this process the fusion of somatic cells occurs. That's why this type of copulation is known as the somatic copulation and this type of sexual reproduction is known as the somatogamy. Now there is also one important a category of a sexual reproduction in fungi, that is spermatization. Spermatization also happens in the family of basidiomycetes such as Puccinia, rust fungus such as Puccinia, in which the male gametes that are known as spermatia. You can see in the picture also spermatia which is produced on the spermogonia which is the tip of a hyphae. This is uninucleate non-motile spermatia are passively transferred by the insects to the repetitive female hyphae leading to the plasmogamy and the male nucleus then pass into the female receptive hyphae and fuse to the. After discussing plasmogamy, karyogamy and meiosis in detail, now we come to the type of reproduction which occurs in fungi with the help of the sexual spores. Now as a result of sexual reproduction, sexual spores are produced and these sexual spores are basically fewer in number than the asexual spores. Basically the sexual spores are produced when the unfavorable condition prevails. There are many types of the sexual reproduction.
There are many types of sexual spores produced in the life cycle of the fungi. Some of the main types, first is ascospores. Now, as you can see in the picture itself, ascospores is the characteristic spores of the largest group of fungi, and the like Ascomycota or Ascomycetes. They are also called meiospores and are formed inside the developing ascus as a result of the nuclear fusion immediately followed by the meiosis. These ascus, it is usually a sac-like structure, and in which a single cell spores are produced. These spores are known as ascospores. These ascospores are produced in a sac-like structure. It is known as ascus. Usually there are 4 to 8 ascospores in an ascus, but the number may vary from species to species. These ascospores are usually arranged in a linear order. In some cases, ascospores are long, narrow, and sometimes arranged in a parallel order. Now, second type of spores are known as the basidiospores. Now, these basidiospores are the sexual spores which is characterized by the large group of fungi, that is Basidiomycota or Basidiomycetes. Now, in comparison with the morphological diversity of the ascospores, basidiospores are more uniform. They are smaller in size of about 3 to 20 mm, which is possibly related to their unique method of discharge. They are normally found in the groups of 4 attached by the tapering stigmata. You can see the stigmata in the picture to the cell wall which bears them. There is a stem-like structure which bears these basidiospores. This stem-like structure or hyphae is known as the basidium. These are basically single cell spores and are born in the club-shaped structure called basidium. These basidiospores arise as a air dispersal unit in the brown spores in the first picture. As you can see, it is known as the zygospores, and these zygospores are sexually produced by the resting structures after the plasmogamy between the gametangia, which are uniformly or morphologically similar. In the second picture, you can see there are the 2 hyphae, plus and minus, which are the morphologically similar, which unite together to form the zygospore. This type of reproduction occurs in the class Zygomycota. Usually these zygospores are large, thick walled, warty structures with abundant lipid reserves. And basically, these type of zygospores are produced during the unfavorable condition. As they are heavy in their structure, as they are heavy, so they can't move to long distances for the dispersal. They await for the favorable condition to appear for germination. The 4th type of spores is known as the oospores. These oospores is sexually produced spore which develops from unequal gametangial copulation or due to the copulation of unequal organs. And it is a characteristic sexually produced spores of the class Oomycota. The oospores which produce of the copulation, these oospores are also known as oogonium. In this whole video, we have discussed type of reproduction in fungi, like vegetative type of reproduction, asexual type of reproduction, and the sexual type of reproduction in detail. So these all includes the main part of the reproduction in fungi.